Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and today I'm here with a tag video, and this tag is evaluating my eyeshadow palette collection tag. And this is created by Rachael Stephanie. I will leave her channel and video down in the description. I saw this at Paulina's channel and I thought it was a fun tag, and this is 8 questions regarding palettes, so I think we just get started. So question number 1, what was your first eyeshadow palette? And I have done another eyeshadow palette tag, and then I said I thought it was a palette from H&M, one of their, I think it was 36 pan palette. I can leave the picture here. I think that was my first eyeshadow palette, what I can remember that was my first. I'm not 100% sure, but I think it was my first. I have owned like some single shadows, like some nude single shadows and a white, I think, but that was my first palette, I'm pretty sure. Question number 2, which palette do you use the most? And yes, I have to read the question, and I think it is the Infinite palette by Linda Hallberg. But this was also a little bit hard because I don't use this for like my eyes. But this is the palette I use the most, both to my eyebrows and my base, and sometimes my eyeshadow as well. Because my other palettes, it's no palette that I use like on a daily basis, but I think this is my most used palette. Before I used this so much for my eyes, like just to have some eyeshadow on, but I think this must be my most used eyeshadow palette. Question number 3. If you had to get rid of one right now, which palette would you choose and why? And I would say... I would say this one. And this is the collaboration between Kat Von D and Too Faced. And this is like the most boring palette I have. I have used this once. And I'm like looking at it and it's like, what am I going to do with it? I don't think it suits the Kat Von D. I just don't... What? I could get rid of this, but I like won't, because I don't want to only keep the Kat Von D. I have thought about selling this, but it feels like strange to sell a half palette, but I could get rid of this. I wouldn't be sad if this broke. I don't like this at all. Like, these 4 are shimmers and these 2 are matte. And yes, you're supposed to use this with the Kat Von D, but the Kat Von D you can use on its own. But this one? No. I don't like this at all. Question number 4. Do you have a deep emotional connection with any of your palettes? Which one and why? And I have to say Urban Decay Naked 2. I have tried to declare this so many times, and I don't know if I can show you because some of the shadows are loose. I have used this a little. Some of the shades are really used, but this was the first expensive palette I bought, and I bought it when it was hard to get Urban Decay in Sweden. I bought this when me and my boyfriend had our first trip outside of Sweden, no. But our first fly. Okay. Where I live, it's not that far to Denmark and Copenhagen, so we have been to Copenhagen. But I bought this in London, and it was like our first real trip together, and it was the first expensive palette I bought, and I was like, I was so happy when I bought this, and I can't get rid of it. I don't use it anymore, but I can't get rid of it because it reminds me of how happy I was. I don't think I have ever been so happy with an eyeshadow palette. I just love it, and like the first time I used it, it was amazing. So this one has a very special place in my heart. I think I can never get rid of this. I've tried, but I can't. I just can't. And you here, it's so broken. Question number 5. Which palette was the biggest waste of money? And That was a little bit hard for me to choose a palette, but I think it has to be Urban Decay Naked Ultimate Basics. And it looks like this. This is a pretty expensive palette. Maybe, well, Urban Decay is expensive, but this one... The story behind this is I bought it because I was like, if I have this, I don't need the other Naked palettes, but I have the other Naked palettes left and I have this, and it's just like, I don't know. It's some fun shades in it. Like this one, Extra Bitter. Okay, maybe just one. It was such a waste of money. I have used it maybe 5 times. I have done 3 looks 1 palette with this. It's like, I don't like it. I don't know why I bought it. I wasn't like happy when I got it home. I don't know. Total waste of money. And it feels like it's so plastic. I don't like the feel of it. I don't like it. Okay, question number 6. Which palette was the biggest surprise to you? That you ended up loving more than you thought, or not liking as much as you expected? And I have taken some that I love more than I ever thought I would, and that is the Kaleidos. Yeah, this is 3 palettes, but I took them as 2, as 1. The Futurism collection. The other 2 are on the way to me, but right now, when I'm filming this, I only have these 3. I thought that these were going to be good, but not so good that I think they are now. These are some of the absolute best palettes I own. I love them so, so much. They are so good. They are amazing to work with. These are just like 3 of my absolute favorite palettes. I thought I was going to like them, but I love them so, so much. All 3 of them are super good. The quality is amazing. The packaging, I really like it. They like blew my expectations. It's 3 of the best palettes I have ever tried. Question number 7. Do you have a palette you never reach for? Which one and why? And I have a lot of palettes that I don't reach for, because I have over 70 palettes and I don't reach for them all. But one palette that I wish I reached for more, it's Modern Renaissance from Anastasia. I have done 3 looks 1 palette. I have also done a face off with this one with Alex. I just wish that I would reach for this more, but when I want to do something neutral and something toned down, I either take the Infinity palette or I take the Soft Glam from Anastasia. I like never reach for this. It is a nice palette, but it's nothing for me. I don't really know why I bought it. Maybe it was a little bit of a completionist in me, and it's like everybody have it, but I never reach for this. Never. It's never like, oh, I want to use a certain shade from that one. Never. And the last question, question number 8. Do you have any palettes where you love all the shades? And Paulina, in her, when she did this tag, she was like, I'm not going to take a palette for more than 1 question. And I thought that was like a great idea, because then you have more, I can talk about more palettes, because the Kaleidos, I love like all the shades in these palettes, but I have taken out 1 that I absolutely love all shades, and that is the Tri palette by Juvia's. It looks like this, if you didn't know. I love all the shades. Really, really like all the shades. I wouldn't change a thing with this, because I love them all and I think they all have a place in this palette. I have a lot of palettes that I love almost all the shades. But it's like always 1 shade that I don't like the Creepy Cute. I don't like the gray in that one. If it was something else than the gray, I would love it. But in this one, I love all the shades. I wouldn't change a thing about this. I love them so much. So this is the palette I took. I only wanted to take 1 palette. I think maybe I have some more, but this one is... I love this palette so, so much. I really need to use it more. But yeah, the Tri Palette by Juvia's is perfect. And that was all for this video. I really hope you liked it. And don't forget to check out Rachael Stephanie and also Paulina to see what they have to say about palettes. And what is your palette that you love all the shades in? Like all the shades in. So yeah, I really hope you liked this video. And if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos. And I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!